So first time I saw Lillian was when we started working together, and this was about July, August 2012, and I'd already been there a couple of months when she joined. So by the time she joined, I was kind of told to give her some training, and that was the first time I saw her. And yeah, I hadn't known at that time what was about to unfold 5 years later, but she seemed so amazing as a person, and it was really good to get to know her as a friend. So we'd been going out for a couple of months, and it was coming up to Christmas. And I just remember Christmas was amazing. I actually went to South Africa with my family that year, and when I came back to see her and to be with her, I think that was really when I knew that I wanted to be with her for the rest of my life. So for me, that was 3 or 4 months after we started dating, which I think is quite early, but for me, I knew. Definitely, on our first anniversary, we went to Lanzarote, and it was really great because we were supposed to go to this nice, kind of swanky bar hotel and have some drinks, and it ended up being shut. So we found some karaoke bar in Lanzarote, which was not the greatest place, not the kind of place you'd like to go for your anniversary. And we just had such a fantastic night doing karaoke, meeting all different kinds of people, got a little bit tipsy. And on the walk home, I just remember the walk home was about 25, 30 minutes, quite a long walk. But just that time, it was just amazing to be with her on our anniversary, and be a little bit tipsy and just really connect. So for me, that's one of our best memories.
Do
you
want me to read it out? Yeah.
Oh,
he's written it in fountain pen.
Oh,
and it's a posh paper.
Yeah.
Special
payment.
At least you have a GSM.
Yeah.
Only
the best.
Dear Lillian, over the last 5 years, I could not have asked for a better friend.
Oh, I don't
know. She's a friend. She's a whole letter, Lily.
Bless her.
Okay.
You have taught me so much, and I'm better for it. As we move into our next chapter together, I would like to make you this promise. I promise that I will do whatever it takes to make you smile.
And every day, for the rest of our lives together, yours always, Mary.
Oh.
Don't cry, you've got makeup.
Stop.
You've got makeup.
We
have
makeup.
Oh my God.
Your matchy matchy with your box. Yeah, yeah. Oh, I like that. I like that. What does it say? Oh, love, laughter, happier after. Oh, I've got that one. That's good.
It's got an LW on.
Oh.
Oh,
what was we talking about last night? You need
about a necklace with a new
you
name.
You said
a
new name, Mum. We said that, yeah.
I know you too well, Lil.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a medicine ball.
Oh. Mm. Has it got something on it, huh?
No. Oh, this is lovely.
No,
welcome to the service of holy matrimony between Rowan Victor Williams and Lillian Rachel Ellen Squires. I've been here for 9 years now, and this wedding is remarkable in that it started bang on time. So I think we owe that to Lillian. Thank you very much, Lillian. The last wedding that George and I did here, we were, I think, about a half hour held up, and Mighty George played and played and played till he was sore up in the organ loft. So on behalf of George, Lillian, thank you for being so wonderfully on time. The service is found in its entirety in the service booklet in your hands. If you participate as boldly as you possibly can, the bride and groom would really appreciate that. Their hymn choices are splendid, as are the readings they've selected. I have to share that it was probably a year or two ago that Rowan first contacted me here at the college to say that he wanted to be married. And those of you who are churchy and ecclesiastical and geeky enough to have something to know about the Church of England will maybe appreciate this joke. Rowan's subject line in his email to me was, "Rowan Williams - I want you to marry me." I have to say, I nearly clicked the delete button, but I did in fact open that email, and here we are today. Thank God especially for this wonderful day and for the sunshine, which is going to continue as long as Lillian and Rowan need it to. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And also with you.
God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Together let us say the opening prayer.
God, the wonder and the joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with living hearts. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
We remain standing for the opening hymn.
letter from St. Paul to the Colossians, chapter 3. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another in any of you who has grievance with someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you, and over all of these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity.
In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Lillian and Rowan, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty which all should uphold and honor. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Rowan and Lillian are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. All good? Yeah. The vows you are about to take are made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Rowan, will you take Lillian to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Lillian, will you take Rowan to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him so long as you both shall live? Will you, the families and friends of Lillian and Rowan, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Rowan and Lillian, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. The second reading read by Patrick Slaughter and Cindy Holland. Would again you please be seated.
your significant other. An example of this is to present your loved one with 12 red roses.
These traditions are beautiful and touching and still uphold by many couples around the world to this day.
In this modern day and age, many people express their love for one another via the internet. There are many options to choose from, ranging from Facebook posts, Instagram pictures, and tweets on the popular social media outlet Twitter.
A tweet, for those of you who are unaware, is a statement made of less than 140 characters and then posted to the World Wide Web.
As Lillian and Rowan are such a wonderfully avant-garde 21st century couple, we felt it would only be right for us to go with a warm twist on the reading.
And so, ladies and gentlemen,
Lillian and Rowan,
we present you today not with traditional reading, but with 12 tweets of love.
Being deeply loved by someone gives you strength, while loving someone deeply gives you courage.
One universe, 9 planets, 204 countries, 809 islands, 7 seas, and you're able to find each other.
Find someone who will be there for you at 2 a.m. when you're falling apart, but also at 3 p.m. when you love life and they make you love it even more.
The best relationships are the ones that you never saw coming.
Choose love because it is the only true adventure.
Everyone's love story is beautiful, but your own is always your favourite.
Love is when you meet someone who tells you something new about yourself.
The giving of love is an education in itself.
Loving each other was never an option, it was a necessity.
Genuine love involves not only passion, but also commitment and wisdom.
If I had represented how much I loved you, I would hold you in my arms forever.
And finally?
My love for you is a journey, starting at forever and ending at never.
Thank you all for your congratulations.
Absolutely wonderful tweets. And long ago, when tweets weren't the thing, they never should have been the thing for Donald Trump, but never mind. When tweets weren't the thing, we had love songs like those written by Burt Bacharach. And I'm thinking of one in particular. What the world needs now is love and how. And if that was a summary of the mission of Jesus, we couldn't be wrong in suggesting it. Jesus was all about love. And we have a lot of love, very obviously, in our presence, in the persons of Lillian and Rowan here with us today. That's the gift they've offered us, is that love that's spilling forth from them, and we all feel infected by it. That's the right choice of words. In the preface, we hear, marriage is a way of life made holy by God, and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. In this day and age, a lot of people, I think, it's sad, get Jesus wrong. We need only go back to his very first miracle, which, if you'll recall, happened at that wedding in Cana of Galilee. The very first miracle of Jesus was one in which love was the answer. You may recall that he was at a wedding and the wine ran out. The guests were well invited in what was offered. They were well stuck in with the party, and the wine had run out. And so someone came to Mary, the mother of Jesus, and said, we've got a major problem. The party's still going on, and we've run out of wine. So Mary, Jesus' mother, gives him the opportunity for his very first miracle. She says, son, they've run out of wine. She suspected he was a little bit peculiar, a little bit something else, and she wondered what he'd do with this particular situation, and he didn't fail to please. They've run out of wine. Well, nearby there were 8 stone jars, which the Jewish people used for the rites of purification. And these 8 stone jars were about the height of some of our little groomsmen, not small stone jars full of special water. And Jesus did his work, and he suggested to the chief steward, go and check out those jars of purification, 8 of them, stood that tall, and you might find that sorted things out. Sure enough, the stewards went over and they tasted the water that had become wine, and they were amazed because the quality of that wine, even, was far better than that which the guests had currently been drinking. And the final remark is, you have saved the best wine for the last. That was Jesus' first miracle. It shows that Jesus loves a good party. He certainly was no teetotaler, so I think some get that wrong. But the wine is a metaphor or analogy
for the abundance of love that Jesus wanted to bring to this world. 2,000 years ago, he knew that what the world needs now is love and how. Same 2,000 years ago as it is today. So how can we not but celebrate on this occasion with Rowan and Lillian when we have a fine example of profound love between these two? And everyone here I know says what an ideal and model couple you guys make, and you'd better keep up with that trend. Would you please stand for the hymn?
And make your vows in the presence of God and his people. I, Rowan.
I, Rowan.
Take you, Lillian.
Take you, Lillian.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
I, Lillian.
I, Lillian.
Take you, Rowan.
Take you, Rowan.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Rowan and Lillian a symbol of unending love and faithfulness to remind them of the vows and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lillian, I give you this ring.
Lillian, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Rowan, I give you this ring.
Rowan, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Right. Go for it. It hurt. Okay, good.
It's on.
Right hands. Excellent. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Rowan and Lillian have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace, and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Rowan and Lillian in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
God of love, we thank you for the gift of marriage and for the joys it brings. Bless us as we share in this wedding. We thank you for the love which has brought Rowan and Lillian to each other and for their desire to share that love the rest of their lives through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to join with me in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And our final hymn, just before the dismissal, Thine Be the Glory.
Thank you. And I'm paying your attention to the father of the bride, Mr. Peter Squire!
Okay. Famous man many moons ago called Andy Warhol said in the future we'll all be famous for 15 minutes. Well, that's not going to happen today because I've probably got about 10. Right, now. Where are we? Well, this is the moment you've all been waiting for, I guess, because I've got such a good rapport from the audience. Right, Brian and her father's speech. Okay. Well, you were, weren't you? Well, I am, because I know it's coming next, so it's all right, isn't it? Okay, well, I can see we've got a wide range of people here today from a number of different backgrounds. So I'd like to just do a little bit of an icebreaker by going around and just calling out a few countries and what have you, and see what we get. Anybody here from Scotland at all? No.
Yes.
Let's try Republic of Ireland. Top of the morning to you, sir. Sorry, I couldn't think of any more original. Anybody from Wales? All right, moving swiftly. Oh. Okay. I nearly got away with it. Yaki da, what does that mean? Is it rude? Oh, that's all right. I can't read it, I can't leave my glasses on.
Can you find them?
I've found them, yeah. Okay, well, there's more than just Scotland as well. Okay, there's a number of people here from... who have origins in the Indian subcontinent, I believe. I think there's one. Are you the only one? Are you the only one?
No, we have Rowan. We have Rowan.
Come on, speak up. Don't be shy. There must be more than one. Oh, right. Okay, yeah, I can see him. I can see you. Yeah, okay. Now I've got my glasses on. I can... We have two friends here from USA. Sorry about that. Where are you? Okay, that's good. Now the easy one. We have a lot of people here from South Africa. Yay! Oh, that's it. Do I hear a vuvuzela? I thought I heard a vuvuzela just then. Maybe that's not the answer. Anyone from Outer Mongolia? No? Surprisingly. She obviously didn't make it, but we'll come back to her later. Right, I'm going to stop now because it's beginning to sound a bit like Lenny Bruce, I'm afraid, if you know Lenny Bruce. And I hope you didn't mind me having a bit of fun, but just an easy way to start this thing off. But there's a point here to be made, a serious point. When I got married 40-odd years ago, I think apart from one Scotsman, we had everyone else was from England. And in fact, everyone else was... from southern England, so it's even more exclusive. So things have changed a lot over the years, and I have to say for the better. So everyone's here is welcome. I'm really grateful you've all turned up. So anyway, you can all, for one day only, you're all English, okay? Because we're here in this quintessentially English setting in the heart of the countryside. And you never know, it might even rain in a minute. Okay, so please make yourself known to other guests, not just the ones on your table. Please circulate after the tables are cleared, so you get to know each other. So. And afterwards, a party. So. Now I don't know who that was, nothing to do with me, I'm afraid. I have a special affection for the village down the road, Hartley Whitney, because I first came here when I was about 7 years of age. I drove overnight in my uncle's car, my sister probably remembers, and we slept in a house which is still there. It's a property called The Limes in the High Street, It's a Queen Anne building. I think it's an antique dwelling, an antique shop or whatever now. So it's still there. And also, while I was here, I actually, for the first time, saw heather, and I'd always understood that heather only grew in Scotland, so it shows how little much I knew, but... Page two. Stuck together. Right, now. Now I get down to it. Because we have to consider the case of Mr. Rowan Victor Williams. Right, Lillian came to me one day and said she'd met a boy in the office and he'd asked around a number of occasions and she had now agreed to go out with him. So that's determination, that's a good sign, good fun. I didn't read it, Rowan, honestly. I said, well, what's his name then? So she said, Rowan Williams. And I thought, sounds familiar, Rowan Williams. I know a lot of Williams because, yeah, that's quite a common name. Rowan Williams. Somewhere's in her mind. Rowan. Oh my God. She's only going out with a former Archbishop of Canterbury. Anyway, the day came, there's a knock on the door. And there stood this shy, quiet, unassuming, nervous young man. Well, after I paid the milkman, Rowan arrived. Now, ladies, what I'm going to say next, you need to cover your ears, because you might not like this. Because Rowan arrived over an hour late for his date. Now, I can even hear the moan of a lady in Outer Mongolia, because we know how things are with the ladies. I can see your epitaph, Rowan. You may be great, my best date, but you were late on our first date. But anyway, he's moved on since then, and Rowan has really made up for it since, I have to say. With his kindness and his deep love for Lillian. He's even added a new faculty, one of patience. Now, patience is every cricketer knows. What patience makes, do you think patience makes? I'll tell you what patience makes. Patience makes for a long innings. So, bear that in mind. But remember, Rowan, you don't have to be good at everything. Just be as you are, because we all love you as you are anyway, so that's... Otherwise we wouldn't be here today, would we? That's okay. Looking back, I knew things were getting serious when Rowan came to me one day and he said, Pete, he said, he's always very formal. He said, Pete, you've got a lovely daughter. And I said, yeah. I said, Esther's really nice. I said, I said, she's a bit pushy, but you know. But Rama's not undone. As everyone knows, he's not a person who keeps his feelings under wraps. Occasionally, he would come up to me and say, let me take you out for a drink and talk about your daughter, Pete. Well, the meeting never took place, so this is several times he tried this trick. Well, I'm going to call in my marker today, Rowan, so you owe me at least 6 points. So I think tonight I'm going to get very, very drunk. Make it 7. Anyway, some words of advice now from my elderly father-in-law. There's 4 major decisions in life that you make. Firstly, this is the problem with the paper, is buying a car. Yeah, buying a car. Buying a home. Career and choosing a life partner. Right. A nice car gives you a sense of freedom, the ability to travel wherever and whenever you want. It can be a status symbol to impress your friends and maybe catch the eye of the opposite sex, so I'm told. But sadly, that doesn't last. Your own home gives you independence, feeling of comfort and security. If it's your own property, particularly in recent years, it can be also a terrific financial investment. Career is obviously important. as it provides you with a status in life, necessary income to enjoy, to finance an enjoyable lifestyle. But by far the most important decision you make is in choosing your life partner. Get this right and the rest will surely follow. I don't know about the rest of you, but I think Rowan might just have cracked it. What do you all think? Yeah. Well, Rowan, I think you've... Well, Rowan, I think you passed. I think you passed. Okay. Right. Honestly, I'll now turn to Lillian. Boo. It's fair to say that Lillian and I have had our ups and downs over the years. It's fair to comment. Some people have said we're too much alike. Well, maybe so. But after seeing the fabulous dress she is wearing today, I'm not so sure I carried it over into the choice of clothing. Come on, stand up, Lillian. Show us your dress, please. Yeah. I think that's what they call a wow factor. Honestly, I can say that Lillian is kind, talented, generous, loving, funny. And she's written something here, I can't quite read it, Lillian. Oh, well. She also has attitude. I want to give you an example of her kindness. It'll take a bit of a while, so bear with it. Now, consider the situation, if you will. I've just taken possession of my new car. Most sophisticated I've ever owned and perfect for driving my wife around in comfort. But for some reason this time, I decided to help my son with some painting to his masonette. I had two pots of paint in the outside cupboard, one nearly new and one with a secure lid, and the other looked okay, but had a lid that was a bit dodgy. I knew the right one to take, but somehow I got the tins around the wrong way. Did the painting without any problem. On the way home, a pot toppled over. It was in the back seat on the floor. So the well of the back seat was actually soaked. It was a 2.5 litre tin, and it's swimming in gloss paint. I was distraught. I was in a terrible panic when I arrived home. But luckily, Lillian had just called round. Though she was busy that day, she took control of the situation, and with the help of me a bit, got straight down to the task in hand. An hour or so, with a lot of hard work, and two cusses as well, and the use of a number of cloths, I mean, goodness knows how many, we cleaned the car, the floor, the driveway, and the whole lot. She'd managed to do a remarkably good job of cleaning up the car. The car was still a bit stained, but free of liquid paint. Lillian had saved the day. So no procrastination that day, dear. As for talent, in case you were wondering, I'm sure you know by now, it was Lillian, with a lot of support from friends and relatives, who designed the theme of the wedding, the place settings, the menus, the decorations, the presents, pretty well everything. And this is not included in the hotel package, so this is all Lillian's idea. So well done, Lillian. I always feel that Lillian is the glue that keeps our family together. I rely on her to ensure that her siblings don't have squabbles which result in them falling out. Because apart from me, no one likes to argue with Lillian. I think it's just because she's just too nice. That's the problem. This is a sticking bit. Today, you make me very proud. And Lillian, darling, it's all about you today. You needed them. A friend of Lily's, which remains nameless, but comes from Bristol, said to her a while back, if you marry Lily, if you marry Rowan, you will be Lily Willy. Perfect, we've got the email address. Perfect. Squilly, okay. I understand that Rowan and Lillian are off to Mexico on their honeymoon. Well, according to what I know, they're hoping to visit Chicken Pizza or something. I thought they could get one here, but I suppose it's probably hotter out here. Anyway, I hope they have a great time. I'm going to stop now because I'm sure Rowan wants to get back to his mobile phone. And I can see my wife saying, "Say no more." But before us, oh, exactly, yeah. Before I sit down, it's my pleasure to propose the first toast of the evening. And it's one to Rowan and Lillian. So please join me and be upstanding and raise your glasses and wish them a long and happy marriage. So I give you the bride and groom. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ryan.
Ladies and gentlemen, I claim your attention.
Claim.
For the father of the bride's room, Dr. Wayne Williams.
Right, Rowan and Lillian, thank you so much for making this a wonderfully proud day for your mother, Henriette, and I, and for allowing us to share with you in this very special and joyous occasion. I'm honored and grateful to both of you for the opportunity to say a few words. I must tell you, I've lectured in 31 countries around the world, and this is the first time I'm ever reading off a bloody piece of paper. And it's only because of emotions. Paul, don't laugh. As I said, just get a bloody hanky or something. Right, I'm fortunate to have done a lot of public speaking and in the past. So when Rowan asked me, and I should repeat many times, "Dad, are you preparing and writing down a speech?" He became rather concerned when I told him, "Don't worry, son, it's all in my head like most of my other speeches." Well, Rowan, you can relax now. He has the bloody papers. Knowing that I was dealing with a modern, rather talented couple where the husband works for Microsoft and the wife is an accomplished graphic designer, I thought I better prepare something that would fit in with their fast-paced, modern social media world that they live in. So I dived into social media, you'll be pleased to know, did some Google searches about father of the groom's speeches, interacted with many WhatsApp groups around the globe, received thousands of tweets from friends of yours, as well as unknown people that just wanted to say something, good and bad about you, both. I received a vast amount of information through various Instagram accounts, through your own Facebook accounts, and various social media sources. You're in trouble. Interestingly, when I proudly pronounced your wedding on my Twitter account this morning to the 1.6 million followers I have, one of the strangest tweets I got back was from the American presidents, sorry, Helen and Dave, I think wherever they are, from Donald Trump. And he said, and I quote, "Well, that's fake news." I replied to Mr. Trump by tweet, of course, or in his case, it should be twit, and let him know that this marriage between Rowan Williams and Lillian Squires, now Williams, of course, is very real. It's happened, and we're all here to celebrate this with them, for which we're very grateful. Mr. Trump somehow didn't seem to know who Rowan and Lillian are. So I explained to him. Rowan and Lillian are quite honestly two of the very nicest people that you'll ever meet. Those of you, and that's most of you in this room, who know them individually or as a couple, will most certainly agree with me that both Rowan and Lillian are undoubtedly the kindest, most caring, unselfish, thoughtful, supportive, and loving people that you'll ever meet. I'll bugger off, Paul. Rowan was born in South Africa and came to England when we moved here 16 years ago as a family. Rowan went off to Lambrook Haileybury, a really nice school, at the age of 9. Proudly went off to Wellington College, where most of you went to the church service this afternoon. And then going off to university at Kent and graduating finally from the world-renowned Henley Business School. Well, Rowan accomplished much in a short time. And needless to say, Henriette and I are very proud of him. Well, none of this impressed us or gave us as much pride and joy as what we would later have when Rowan proposed to the very beautiful and lovely Lillian. And she agreed to marry him. Bloody hell, were we happy she said yes. For 5 years, I've actually said that if Rowan and Lillian ever had split up prior to their marriage, Rowan was out and Lillian was staying. Well, Rowan and Lillian met 5 years ago. They worked together, apparently, in the same office every day, and yet they still arranged their first date through Facebook. Don't ask, it's complicated. Oh, I know. The very first memory I have of Lillian, or Lil as I like to call her, was those tiny little shoes, Lil, that you left at our front door when you came to visit Rowan for the very first time in our home. Henriette and I noticed the little shoes when we went up to bed that night. And I knew that the friendship between these two very special people was already quite serious when I came downstairs the following morning. And the now famous little shoes were still there. I'm going to be quite honest here. No, Lillian's shaking her head. You're right, Lil, I've never asked about that night. But I've always assumed that you went home barefoot. In seriousness, it was very easy to welcome this wonderful young lady into our home and into our family and into our hearts. With Lillian, it's almost impossible not to love her. In the 5 years we've known you, Lillian, I can honestly say I've never seen you upset. I really haven't. Others have. She has always been fully honest. I'm not going to mention that, Lil. She's never ever spoken badly of anyone. I think there's few people we can say that about in the world. She's courteous, appreciative, caring, always giving encouragement and support when required, and more importantly, just listening when that's required. Rowan and Lillian, true wealth is most accurately measured by the number of friends that you have. Well, the two of you have a huge Swiss bank account right here in this room. Your friends, and indeed Lillian, your family, have traveled from near and far to be with you both today. You are very fortunate to have a full complement of parents at your wedding. Some of your grandparents, all your brothers and a sister here today to be with you. Your aunts, uncles, cousins, second, and in Lil's case, even third cousins. Some have traveled across continents to be here, from South Africa and elsewhere. What a fantastic compliment to both of you. And your friends, well, I've never imagined that a couple as young as you are could be invited to so many weddings, baby showers, meetings about weddings about meetings, christenings, luncheons, dinners, and many social events. You both have, and this is a compliment to all of your friends, amazing friends, Lillian and Rowan. Some of your friends, Rowan, that I saw from Wellington College today, it really was so pleasing. There's a big cohort of them. Very nice to see those guys. Lillian, all your friends who are truly, truly amazing. They all, without exception, are very nice people. By the way, The only very nice, only the very nice friends were invited today. So if you're here, you're very nice. And finally, Lillian, your family. On behalf of the entire Williams family, I can tell you that we are so very proud to be united with the Squires family. Hazel, Pete, Esther, Duncan, and Robert, and each of your extended and married families. Thank you for being as nice as you all are. We are proud to be united with your family. Sorry, did I say United or Arsenal? Sorry. I would like to finish by proposing a toast, but before doing so, I should say that I knew that Lillian and Rowan's marriage would be perfectly normal when, a few weeks ago, I started receiving instructions about the toasts from Lillian. Weeks before the wedding. Not only is Lillian going to be telling you what to do for the rest of your life, Rowan, but she's already telling me what to do in mine. Lil, you kindly told me that your dad, and who gave a wonderful speech this evening, Pete, would be speaking first, and that Pete would be toasting the bridal couple. And Lil said, so Wayne, find someone else to toast. Well, it only took me a few seconds, literally, and that's the honest truth, to decide who I would be proposing the toast to. Without them, you wouldn't be here today, Rowan and Lillian. You would not have been raised to be such wonderful, wonderful, lovely people that you both are. So please be upstanding and share in a toast to the beautiful and charming mothers of the bride and groom, to Hazel and Henriette. Thank you.
Paul, start the timer, please.
Sorry, I broke your watch already. I'll do this one.
Have you actually got a timer?
I'll get one.
Thank you.
Because when he's going to cry.
Matt, be on standby with the package, please.
Right, tell me when you're ready.
Yeah, I'm going. Thank you to Pete and Wayne for their lovely words. And thank you to all of you for coming. It means an awful lot to Lillian and I that you are here to celebrate with us. Firstly, that you managed to find your way despite the disturbing lack of signage and vast amount of winding roads. Now, those of you that know me well know that I need no help with public speaking. But as it's a special occasion, I did some research and found this piece of advice about my speech. To make sure it had a good beginning and a good ending, but most of all, to make sure that they're close together. So I'll do what I can, although David has assured me that he'll step in if I'm too boring. Firstly, I'd like to thank Pete and Hazel. From the day that I met you, you've really made me feel like a part of the family, which I can't thank you enough for. Pete, you've made me more tea than I thought possible.
When you turned up.
Although it does take more than 30 minutes to arrive. So thank you for that. Hazel, you've taught me what it means to be a true Arsenal supporter by shouting at the TV and cursing Arsene Wenger at every point possible. To both of you, I'd like to thank you for raising such a beautiful, kind and caring daughter. It doesn't take long in your company to realise where she gets it from. And while we're on the subject of fantastic children, I'd like to say thank you to my parents for raising such a charming, handsome, and modest son. Although I've no idea where I get those from, so thanks for that. In all seriousness, I'd like to thank you for everything that you've done for me. You've always been here for me. Not yet. And I know you've made me and Lillian feel incredibly welcome, so thank you. And thank you to all of you for your helping today, for your help in making today happen. You've all done so much behind the scenes, and we couldn't have done this without you. So if you could all be upstanding, mums, we've got some flowers for you. I'd like to raise a toast. to the parents. Sorry, you might have to stand up a couple of times, but sit down for now, it's fine. I'd like to say a few words about the bridesmaids, Vicky, Jess, Esther, Christina, and Sammy. I'm sure everyone will agree that I say they look fantastic tonight. You all did such a wonderful job of getting Lillian to the chapel on time, seriously. Like, literally 5 minutes, so that was fantastic. Thank you to Esther for organising the hen do, sweets, and so much more, along with Jess, Christina, and Sammy. Vicky, you did a sterling job with the invites, so thank you. Thank you for that, I really appreciate it. Thank you for always, but mostly, thank you for always being here for my wife. No? Hasn't dropped yet? Through thick and thin. Breathe. So for that, I'd like to raise a toast. You can be seated. To the bridesmaids. Right. Stop. Stop the time.
3:54.
Matt, 3:54. Who was it? Zane. Matt, there's a present for Mr. Zane. If you'd like to open it and present it, please.
Open it. Open it. Church. It's not.
I guessed it. The groom is a crybaby. So Zen, that's going to be waiting for you after I finish crying. Right, where was I? We have got some flowers for Esther and Marissa, just to say thank you for today. Marissa's done a sterling job in terms of running a lot of today, so as I'm sure you'll all agree. So we do have some flowers for Esther and Marissa. Right, so I'd also like to say thank you to my best men, Warren and Matt. We've been friends for as long as I can remember. Warren, my big brother, thank you for taking care of me through the years. You can't always choose your family, but I'm very lucky to have you. Matt, 16 years is a pretty long time to know someone. Neighbour, study buddy at uni, and now that one friend living abroad. There aren't many days I don't go without talking rubbish to you. Thanks for putting up with it. I'd also like to say thank you for such a unique stag do. I'm sure I'll never think of Bournemouth in the same way again. And by the way, I am Spartacus. And thank you to the groomsmen, Paul, Sam and Reese. You are my inner circle, and I know with your support, Lillian and I will be rich with love and laughter forever. So for that, I'd like to raise a toast to Team Groom. No, I'm fine, thank you. I need a napkin. We'd also like to say a massive well done to Henry, George and Edith during the ceremony today. Yeah. Walking in a straight line isn't always easy, as you'll come to learn in about 12 to 16 years. To congratulate you on doing such an awesome job today, we've got some gifts for you, so come up and grab them. I think we've got them. David, have we got the gifts for
yes,
the boys? Thank
I'm
you.
Happy to like, sorry.
Henry?
Henry,
yeah. Well done, boys. You did a fantastic job. Okay. I'd also like to say thank you to Sam and Georgie. Sam, where are you, Sam? Sam, for finding a way to keep those luscious locks in place. And Georgie for turning Beauty and the Beast into a waltzing version of Torval and Dean, as you will soon be finding out. Patrick and Cindy, Roxana, Alistair and Emily, for your beautiful readings. These really mean a lot. Each one of you today has a biscuit in front of you, and you should all be thankful to Michelle, who hand-baked, cut, iced, and decorated each of these on her own. So please raise your glass to the fixers. Penultimately, I'd like to thank those who travelled a long way to be here. My amazing South African family, uncles, aunties, cousins, and grandparents. My best man and Nora from Switzerland. Helen and David, Lillian's godparents from Washington State, USA. Alistair, Emily, Andrew, Sammy, and little Hector from Yorkshire. And Pete, the 9-mile journey from Bracknell. Thank you, it is humbling for you all to be here. And last, but by no means least, my very special wife. So, this part of my speech is actually a bit of a duplicate because most of this has already been said tonight, which I didn't realise. But I'm going to say it anyway. Many of you don't know the story of how we met. I actually trained Lillian when we started working together in 2012. Along with Scott, we were the self-proclaimed comedy duo of the office. So after 2 months of getting to know the new Mrs. Williams, I asked her out. She said no. Being stubborn as a mule, I dropped the hint a second, third, and fourth time, but the answer stayed the same. Before asking the fifth time, I asked her why she wouldn't say yes. Desperate, I know, but worth it in the end, I guess. She said she thought I was joking and that I wasn't being serious. Anyway, I pleaded one last time, something I don't do very often, and she fell for it. I mean, she said yes. She wrote her address down for me, and I was to pick her up Wednesday, 10th of October, 2012, at 7 p.m. That evening, I came home and got ready. As I was about to leave, I realized I had forgotten her address at work. I didn't have her number, and as 7 p.m. came and went, I thought I'd ruined it. But I took to Facebook and messaged her. Unbeknownst to me, Lillian was already in tears, and Hazel was fired up, ready to duff me up if she ever met me for standing up her gorgeous daughter. Lillian saw the message at 8 p.m. and replied with her address. I picked up a slightly pissed off date 20 minutes later and headed to the cocktail bar. Now I'd like to think I was adopting the age-old tactic of treat them mean, keep them keen. What can I say, it worked. 3.5 years later, all I can say is I only had to ask once for Lillian to marry me, so I couldn't have thought she couldn't have thought I was joking then. If I had a penny for every time someone told me I was punching above my weight, when it came to looks with Lillian, I'd probably still be poor thanks to the sweating. But not half as poor. She has the ability to turn Vogue in a split second, which makes me completely stop in my tracks. And I think you all agree, today of all days, she has turned it to the max and looks stunning. Lastly, for those of you that have known me before and at the beginning of our relationship will agree that this being has changed me for the better, teaching me to see the good in others, to be humble, have emotional intelligence, something which is at the core of what Lillian is about. So on that note, I would like you all to raise a glass and be upstanding to the new Mrs. Williams. Thank you.
Well, I've waited a while for this. It's payback time, Rowan. Rowan gave my best man speech 2 years ago at my wedding. So here it goes. Firstly, good evening, friends and family, and thank you all for being here today to celebrate Rowan and Lillian's big day. I think you'll all agree that they've done a brilliant job in choosing spectacular venues which are fit only for a prince and his princess. As you all may know, Rowan is an extremely popular guy. I remember when Matt and I auditioned for the position of best man, because let's face it, he can have a whole army of them. He sat at the front of the stage as if he was Nicole Scherzinger, in his high heels, on the table, showing off his long legs, with a pint of lager in hand, criticizing every element of our performance. Apparently, my South African accent was too thick, so Matt had to step in and be my interpreter, as most of what I was saying could not be understood. So needless to say, when we heard we got the job as his best man, we were extremely honored.
So, just an interpretation of what we just said. So of all the guys in the world, we've got a few words for Rowan, and of course, he is by far the most handsome, strongest, he's very witty, intelligentest.
Hang on, Warren, can you read that, mate? I can't read that.
No, I've got no clue, but then again, I've never been able to read Rowan's handwriting. But seriously, that is the only thing that we can criticize him on. I met Rowan back in the early 90s, and of all places, it was in a small hospital in South Africa. I remember the first time I saw him, he had a whole entourage of nurses surrounding him trying to get his attention. And from that day, he's been a hit with the ladies. We got on so well. We dressed in matching clothes, got matching haircuts, ate at the same dinner table, even shared bath times together. We pretty much did everything together and were totally inseparable. It's fair to say he's always been like a brother to me.
So what I've also actually looked forward to this moment for a long time. It'll be the first time I've actually been able to speak for 2 minutes in Rowan's presence without being interrupted. And for those that you don't know me, I've been Rowan's long life British counterpart, having met from pretty much day one when he was merely 8 years old. And Warren, if you just hold the mic, I've actually got a picture from him from when we first met.
That is it, right there. You can kick that one.
So that particular day, it was one lovely, calm summer afternoon. I was playing outside the front of my house with a neighbour of mine. And Rowan, this human ball on a scooter just bowled down my road one day. 8 years old, I remember. And he was coming straight towards me. Oh, Christ, he was going to come straight towards me, but at the last second he swung left.
Ooh.
But it wasn't that, it wasn't inside joke. It wasn't his appearance that caught me off guard. It was, in fact, his thick, long, well, sorry, long. His long lost, thick South African accent. Here we go. It went something a little long like this.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
Hello? Yo? Yeah, my name is Ryan. And will you be my friend?
Sounds like that. Now, Matt and I have a very deep and dark secret to share about Rowan. To this day, nobody else knows this, and Rowan made us pinky promise that we would never share the story of his first love. His first love was tall, great with children, a great singer and dancer, extremely popular and a total celebrity around the world. It was no wonder they hit it off from the very first time they laid eyes upon each other. Let's give you a hint. Now, Rowan was infatuated with this little purple Barney bear. He carried it everywhere with him as a little boy. And we went to Disneyland when he was only 3 or 4, and you should have seen his little face. I mean, it was like this when he saw Barney for the first time in Disneyland. So Rowan has all the characteristics of a true gentleman. He's very easy to live with and extremely well house trained. However, this wasn't always the case, and when he was a little boy, it wasn't always so easy to get him to help with the chores around the house. Rowan's classic stunt that he used to pull when it came to helping clear the table or change the bins was that he needed to go to the loo, where he would remain for at least 30 minutes until he was confident that someone else would have done his chores for him by the time he got out. Rowan is also very intelligent and inquisitive. As a boy, he would pick up a new toy or gadget and look deep into its soul, trying to figure out what was inside it and how it worked. So much so that he used to take everything apart that he could find to feed his curiosity, except once dismantled, he could never put it back together again. Hence the nickname, the Terminator. Rowan is a huge fan of fishing, except in the beginning, it was quite difficult for him to grasp how it all works. When he was a little boy, my opa, and in my language Afrikaans, opa is your grandfather, on my mum's side, Rowan and I went on a fishing trip together with my opa. We left before sunrise and had done a lot of prep for the long day ahead. When we arrived, my opa and I set up camp and prepared the rods. Meanwhile, in the car, Rowan was also busy. He had gotten hold of the cooler bag with all our food and also all the bait. Oh, no. South African fish love bread and corn, and when we found Rowan, he'd completely demolished all the bread and corn. We had nothing left as bait, so we had to pack up and retire home early.
We also have some very fond memories of Rowan, of which certainly our endless attempts at trying to replicate Arsenal's incredible performance on FIFA, which has been very easy in recent years. but I also have some very fond memories of us in our young teenage years ice skating. Without fail, every week, Rowan and I would pitch up down at the ice rink, and with having Rowan along with me, with prowess, he would strut his stuff. Showing off with so much perseverance in learning his new skills, whether that be speed skating or spinning around in the middle of the ice and doing his pirouettes. Mostly to impress the girls, but even if his scripts are far away from perfect, he naturally, in his own way, would still show them off. And Rowan forever has since been able to have this ability to make things seem incredible, whatever situation they may be. And of course, it meant that he was destined to have an exceptional career in marketing. And of course, the proudest moment was seeing Rowan. I was there to witness Henry the school to receive his award for best business student. So I thought I'd present this picture of him moments before receiving his award. But jokes aside, I think we can all agree that Rowan has never wanted as anything as much as putting a smile on Lillian's face and to make her as happy as she can be. Lillian, you have found much more than a husband, somebody that has not allowed a day to pass without putting a smile on your face, and I've been a witness of that. And he has helped us through so much, myself included, and of course many people in this room as well. The two of you will create a future of wonderful laughs and adventures, and to share that with our family and friends in this room today. So thank you all so much for coming, and hopefully a couple of little ones for a few years. So we're all praying for them. Let's take off Lillian, because of course we don't want to see that picture again. You're welcome.
Right, so just before we finish, can everyone just make sure that your glasses are charged? We've got one final toast coming, and it's the most important one of the evening. It's to Lil. It's great to have another addition to the Williams family. Excuse me, and Rowan could not have done a better job in finding a more perfect partner. You two make the perfect couple, and we wish you both a lifetime of happiness. So here's a toast to my brother Rowan and my new sister Lillian. Thank you.
and the bride will put their wedding cake. Will you help me? One, two, three! Hold the poles, put the knife back in the cake, hold the poles, and look at your best. That's good enough. Right, now the peacock guests, and give them time to take a photograph.
I found a love for me. Darling, just dive right in, follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. But darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, your between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath that you heard it. Darling, you look my dreams. I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found a love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own.
Today, and we hope you have the best of luck in the future, a happy marriage, and a great honeymoon in Cancun. And we hope you can come over and see us sometime in the next few years, and we'll do our best to be good hosts for you. Thanks a lot.
Have a wonderful time in Cancun, and we really have enjoyed today. Thank you very much for asking us. We really appreciate it. It's been great. You take care and have a wonderful honeymoon.
Hey, Lil and Rowan. Guys, you look amazing. I'm so happy for you guys. And honestly, I hope you have the most wonderful life as Mr. and Mrs. Rowans. And I just want to say, I am Spartacus!
Hi, Rowan and Lillian. It's wonderful to be here with you. I'm delighted that I could be part of this new start in your lives. I know you've been together for a while, but this is such a wonderful step for both of you, and I can't tell you how honored I am to be part of it. I wish you all the best, and I look forward to some amazing moments together with you in the future.
Hi, Rowan and Lillian. Thank you so much for all the happy times you spent leading up to the wedding. And thank you for inviting us. Grandpa and I have had a wonderful time. We love you very much. And I'm getting emotional. And we wish you all the best and a wonderful future. You're a wonderful couple. We're very proud of you. Lots of love.
Lots of love, guys.
And hugs.
Yep.
Rowan Lillian, on this special day of yours, we wish you all the best in life, health, happiness, and the rest. Honestly, as dare I say it, you're one of your very good friends. You know, Rowan, I've known you since you were 13 years old. We've been through a lot of times at school, and I can say that, you know, from the day I met you, you've been fantastic, mate. You know, you are humble. You've been grateful about everything we do, and both of you deserve each other. I can see you both enduring a fantastic life together. But more recently, you know, we've had some great evenings together. I am privileged and very grateful to have you as my friend, and also both of you as a sort of relationship role model. And you know, Emma and I both very much value your friendship, but also our relationship with you. So that's everything from me.
And now over to me.
Over to you.
Well, the big brother house.
I know I can't cook very well, but maybe Emma can indulge in some recipes for us.
We've had a brilliant day today. It's been amazing with such lovely friends and company, and it's been amazing. It's lovely to be here and enjoy the wedding with you. Back to you.
By the way, you know, we've got many leftover small baby grows, baskets, a lot. So when you do finally buck up the idea to have children, Phoebe's very much looking forward to having a friend. So go on, do it. All the best, you guys. Honestly, I'm truly grateful to even be associated with you guys. I wish you all the best. Take care.
Hi, Lil One. Now, geez. Yeah, but in that video, millions. Jeez, it sounds weird. But yeah, just saying, fucking hell, man. Known you guys since uni. Seeing you guys come, you know, just together. Like, you know, it's amazing. So happy you're married now. You know, obviously, it's about time, obviously. But yeah, just I know, you know, you guys like perfect together. You both like trying to do your own thing and like just come together and helping each other. That's crazy. So yeah, I'm really happy for you guys and. Just yeah, have loads of adventures together, love each other, and yeah, hope for you to a great life. Cheers.
Hi, Rowan and Lillian. Congratulations. Good luck, and enjoy your honeymoon. And we can't wait to see you once you get back. All the best in the future.
And enjoy your honeymoon to Mexico. I'm sure it'll be great, and have a great time. And we'll see when you get back, and you come around our new flat.
Love you lots, guys. See you soon.
See you soon. Bye.
Hi, Rowan. Hi, Lillian.
Hi, Rowan. Hi, Lillian. Lovely to see you.
Congratulations. Well done. We hope you're really, really happy together. You have a fantastic life. Thank you very much for inviting us. It's been lovely to see you both looking so happy and so joyous this evening. And we've had a lovely time, haven't we?
Yes, we have. Thank you.
So thank you for inviting us, and we hope to see you again soon.
Very soon.
Bye.
We haven't thought this one through, have we?
Yeah, we have.
Have we? Okay. Hello.
Hi there.
Beautiful people.
Probably exhausted, overexcited, and not really sure what's going to happen to you.
Even in the next few years, when you look back through this again, you'll think you're still exhausted and nothing's changed. But other than you're still in love and you're still together and
so are we.
Hopefully.
If you can believe it.
No, we want to take this special opportunity to thank you guys for being very strong driving forces in our relationship and actually getting us to know each other and getting us to believe in each other and see each other for who we are.
Absolutely. This is certainly deeper than I'm sure any of the other messages on the camera, because obviously we're here for the wedding and we just wanted to say thank you, because
this is amazing. It's stunning. And
it's been wonderful and beautiful setting, been a beautiful day. The weather was stunning, the venue was stunning, everyone was beautiful and
had an amazing
time. You guys were fantastic and the speeches were wonderful and everything. So that was all of that, but I guess we should just say a really big thank you, because at the end of the day, Mr. Rowan Williams, you're a bit of a cupid. Introducing us to a little while ago.
Even if we will never lift us down.
Yeah, and I'm just really sorry that I've left you. But you've got Lillian now, it's all okay.
And hopefully we can pay you back for this wonderful day by hosting something similar, not that grand, but similar.
Yeah, we're having you in Switzerland, and it's not just going to be the once for the all, you know, we're treating you in Switzerland, of course, But there'll be many, many more adventures, both in Switzerland, in the UK,
all over
anywhere in the world. Rowan, me, you still need to go on a trip outside the country, so we're well overdue on that one.
Yeah, and Lillian will just go shopping while they do stupid stuff as usual.
Absolutely. So we just wanted to say that we love you
so much.
We've had a lovely day. We've still got a long night ahead, but we know it's just going to be marvelous.
Yeah, and we have a lovely life together because of the two of you, and so we will forever be thankful for thank you. Love you lots.
We love you. Love you guys. Hashtag Lil Wan.
Hashtag Lil Wan wedding.